I'm gonna pass out, it's, when you get this, it's on the second, it's on the back side of this, here on the front, there's the front page, just flip it to the back side. And ideally, in a playroom, you want one of everything a child could encounter in their life, just about, one of everything. But that's, for yourself, if you're the kind of therapist that has to share offices, as so many do, if you're working in the schools and you need to have something you can tote from room to room, here is a portable play therapist. This is a list of essential toys and materials you'd need to create a portable play therapy room. And some of the things that might surprise you would be the nursing bottle, like the baby bottle. A lot of kids want to be able to revert to that baby stage because they're just not allowed to. We expect so much of children today, but to give them the power to choose to revert. A rubber knife, so kids is safe. It's a way that if they have aggression or violence, it's a way for them to express it. Clay, Play-Doh, dart gun, handcuffs. Something interesting because kids sometimes feel they need to control. You know, I'm gonna handcuff you to your desk, Kim, and are you okay with that? How a lot of being a play therapist reflects how comfortable you are with yourself and how much you trust your clients. And we'll talk about that later. Toy soldiers, dishes and cups, spoons, airplane, car, Lone Ranger type mask. Giving kids a chance to have a mask to kind of hide behind a different persona. They can act things out metaphorically if they're given a mask because it's not like, it's not me, it's just someone dressed up. I can do this. Some art supplies, bendable figures, an aggressive hand puppet or some kind of aggressive figure so kids can safely express their aggression, or if someone is aggressive against them, it gives them a way to symbolically represent that versus having to talk about being bullied. They can have puppets that are acting out kind of bullying behaviors. A telephone, doll families, a small cardboard box with rooms marked, because a lot of kids enjoy the dollhouse. Even little boys will enjoy it because they know domestic life. That's one thing, kids, school or domestic life. And it gives them a kind of way to act things out. And also, you can watch where they place furniture, what they have the dolls doing to interact. Costume jewelry, dressing up. So kind of the basics here are things, if you're on a limited budget, but you do want to have a playroom or a play box set up, these are the things you need. Ideally, you go online, one of the wonderful supply companies has been, you know, $1,000 to set it up, or you can go to the dollar store and get basically everything on this list for, well, 25 items, $25, there you go. So you've got some options, but you really do want to have something of everything. Things up there, even like the gun and the knife, the baby bottle, very diverse items, but you want the child to be able to express any feelings they've got going on, and every child will be different. It'd be amazing. In your playroom, there may be some absolute limits. The child will not hurt himself or the therapist as part of the play. No intentional breakage of toys. Clinical limits, all the toys should remain in the playroom. The child should not leave the room until the session's over. And when the session is over, the child must leave the room. These are really important because you want play therapy to be the space. And so it's got to have, you want it to be contained. A lot of times kids can be out of control, but if you say you'll be in here this long, the things that are in here will be here next week, it gives children a sense of security and consistency that are really important. Reactionary limits need to be created when the child's about to spill paint all over the toys or when something's about to happen. And there may be times where you have to come up with a new limit, but you want to do it the whole idea of logical consequences. Becky, if you spill paint on the toys, then the toys won't be able to be used by you or the other kids. So let's not spill paint on the toys. And you want to let kids know and be very calm. If you're the kind of person who jumps, you know, about, you know, oh my gosh, don't do that, then you've got to really wean yourself away from that. You've got to be really calm, cool, and collected, and be patient with kids. Just, you have to offer that calmness and the presence that reactionary responses to that they really put into jeopardy if you don't know how to maintain equilibrium. And learning to let kids be messy, I think, can be very hard for a lot of therapists.